morning, guys, and welcome to this video. We are headed to the gym, but like what I like to do is drink a lot of water throughout the day, and I squirt these little Crystal Light things. I also have some Mio for when I go out to the bar because this has electrolytes and vitamins, so I squirt it in like my vodka soda, and I'm super healthy, right? And some people are like, oh my gosh, Max, that's so girly, dude. Bring a little Mio in your pocket, you loser. Just drink an IPA beer or some whiskey like in the men, dude. But then when I'm like squirting this in, some like my friends are like, hey, Max, can I have a little squirt? It's still for chicks, but just give me a little bit.
Picked up a new sex toy. We have the new DJI Mavic 2 Pro. I'm gonna do an entire video on this soon, but not right now. Let's go.
I know, I'm really cool. I can lip sync. I know. Hey, guys, I know. Get over here. By the way, Maxi Poo's review of the new Eminem album, Kamikaze, 10 out of 10. And anyone who does not like Eminem, your opinion is irrelevant and you don't matter. So I just became aware of this Machine Gun Kelly Eminem diss. Now I kinda like Machine Gun Kelly, but I don't think it's a good move to go after Eminem. The dark road he's walking down, Machine, don't do it! Stop it! All right, guys, so we are starting our new training regimen. Our coach is none other than Mr. Brett Gibbs. If you're not aware of him, let me put some clips on the screen right now.
Squat!
In order to get stronger, you sometimes must go back down in weight. So we're working with a lower weight today. Normally with like bench, squat, deadlift, I'm always in like the 85 to 90 some percent, working for doubles and triples. Brett says that's not optimal. So we're starting exactly how he says. We're gonna work with what he wants us to do to a T. Today, 225 pounds. We're doing 3 sets of 5 to start off, but we're doing a 3-second competition pause. And one thing that Brett told me for every single lift is that when I'm in my competition, workouts, my bench, squat, my deadlift, to treat every single rep as if I'm on the platform. So everything is gonna go in with that mental game. I'm gonna make sure that all my cues are good. I'm gonna go in with 100% confidence that I can execute the lift. And he says this will carry over in the long run. So we're building up our strength and then we'll peak closer to the meet. So I'm excited to start this and I'm just excited to overall just get stronger and be on structure for the main compound lifts. I really do like having specific numbers to hit. So I've been kind of yoling it in the past and it has worked for me up into a certain point, but I really do think that structure is your friend. So a training technique that we're working with on this program all for our accessories is gonna be the RPE scale, which is on the screen. It is rates of perceived exertion. I've seen a lot of people have great success with this. It's essentially working off a scale where you have like more reps in the tank and you base it off of numbers. So for example, RPE 7 means you have 3 more in the tank. It's just so you don't go to failure every single time, which is what I've done, you know, throughout my entire lifting career. So I've never been a fan of the RPE scale, but we're gonna do it, okay? We're gonna do what the doc orders. So this is our top set, RPE 9, which means I should be able to get this for 10 reps with 1 more in the tank. So the 10th rep should be kind of a struggle, but I should have like 1 more in the tank. Working with 95 pounds.
Nine, 10.
So that was actually pretty good. I think I maybe had one. That might have been RP 8. Like I maybe could have done like 2 more if I really struggled. So I'm really excited to start in some actual programming. Now, generally when I lift, I, you know, like to have fun in the gym and I like to enjoy myself with my friends, but I also want to take this very seriously because I want to get strong. And if you guys didn't know, if you're new to my channel, my bench press is not my strongest lift, and we are putting a big emphasis on that because we're on the road to hit 315, right? Can we do it? That'll be the end of my channel. Like, I don't need to watch any more videos, Max. I've already seen it. So I want to show you as much as possible without giving you all the information. Each week, Brett is going to hand over the new program for that week. So I'm just ready. I'm ready to get strong. I'm ready to show you guys that, you know what? I can stick to something and I can commit. Also, we have a big update because our dude flexed in the gym. Flex, dude, do you have a minute for an interview? I know that you took the internet by storm in 2017 and even in 2018. I know you haven't been featured that much recently, but I need to know, how does it feel? Flex, dude, come here, dude. How does it feel to know that Dude the Doodle is soon gonna overtake you on the sickest doggo train? You don't care? You just wanna get away from me? Okay. All right, we'll talk later, dude. Money, hungry? That's a cool shirt.
Thanks.
Do any of y'all have like a friend group where whenever you go anywhere, you're always the one to drive? That's me.
You have the best car. I always drive.
No, you didn't.
I often drive.
No, you didn't.
I mean,
what do you say?
What's better, turkey burger or chicken burger?
I can't remember. Turkey, dude. Ooh, apple pie milkshake. Guys, apple pie is my favorite pastry dessert. So I don't know how I'm gonna feel about a milkshake, but it tastes like pumpkin though. It's like pumpkin apple pie. Anyway, we got ourselves a turkey burger, pepper jack cheese on pretzel bread and sweet potato fries, which are way superior to regular fries. We're gonna add a little bit more mustard. Hey look, 100% natural. This thing should start an IG and tell you to buy its program, right? Get it? That's a fake natty joke. Anyway, guys, I haven't decided for this meet what I want to do in terms of weight. Do we just go all out and go like, you know, full loco on the bulk and just get up like real heavy?
Yeah.
No, don't say shredded.
Say shredded.
Shreds are gone.
Team,
yeah, but do I do the Christian method where like he just eats
like butter?
He just eats everything and says it's bulking, but like, I think a better way to do it is just add maybe like 50 carb and you do that for a little bit. But Christian's just like. All right, so we are going to see Crazy Rich Asians and I'm not gonna bring the camera in, so I'll let you know how it is when I'm done, all right? Movie review, it was pretty good. Mona, what'd you think?
I thought it was
cool seeing people like so in love and like so happy, and it was like made me happy seeing other people happy. It just kind of sucks that like that kind of like beautiful like things that it was in the movie, like that could never happen in real life. Let me close the door for you. Yeah. So for dinner, I was craving some chips and some salsa and maybe a margarita. So we're gonna try out this place called Cyclone Anaya's. And it has actually terrible reviews on Yelp. But sometimes, you ever like, something so bad that you're like, I gotta test it out for myself. It's like when something's like really, really stinky and your friend's like, hey, come smell this, it smells so bad. And you're like, okay, I'm gonna come over there. It's kinda like when people like come to my channel that like dislike all my videos, but like they won't just unsubscribe. Like they're like, oh my God, Max put another video, I have to go watch it. Well, I can tell by how busy it is that it's a very popular restaurant. So without like being super creepy, you see all these people like back here, is that what you do when you get older? You're just like, hey Becky, do you want to go to the park and sit on the bench? Yeah, John, I would love to do that. That sounds like a lovely afternoon. Maybe we can go after we go to brunch. Let's go ahead and start the review of this restaurant. First up, the chips, okay? They went with a thicker chip. Not to be confused with the Chewy's chip, which is a thin chip, which is fantastic. Now, this type of salsa, I'm just gonna go ahead and say, I'm not a huge fan of the kind of like pasty, this looks like soup, right? I'm more of a pico de gallo kind of fan. So, I mean, they're gonna take some points, knock down that, but we're gonna go and try it out, see how it tastes. They did redeem a little bit of points because it is a little bit spicy, but personally, I like a little more fresh cut tomatoes in there. So keep on watching for the full review of this Cyclone restaurant. All right, next up on the review is the mango margarita. Now, one thing you'll notice is that it appears that they squirted in the mango or the flavoring after the fact, and it's not really mixed up. Because if you look just right here, get a little close-up shot on that. You see all the flavor separation right there? Yeah. Can you see it on the camera?
Yep.
It's not really, it's no bueno. So we're gonna have to mix this up ourselves. Doing a little, see how it's getting consistency in the color, Mona?
Yeah.
You see that? Now it's turning into a complete mango.
There's like a hole.
Oh, we got a squirter. Wait, what?
There's like a hole.
No, it's just seeping over the edge. It's fine. Okay, so we had to mix that up. A little extra work, I'm not gonna complain. Let's try it out. Pretty good, they'll redeem themselves in their points. Good margarita.
Okay, let's go back, no cold.
Oh, what about me? Oh, never mind.
Yep. Mona, can I ask you a question? Why do you choose to go with the non-frozen margarita over the superior frozen margarita?
I don't like that.
You don't get, it's like a alcoholic slush or a Slurpee.
Yeah, I don't like a slush. I like my ass.
Do you feel that you get more when it's frozen or when
no,
it's...
No, because I feel like I get more flavor out of this. This is just like blended water.
No. Next up, we got the food. Now, originally, I was going to take some points off because the drinks did take a long time to come out here, but the food actually came very, very quick before the drinks, so those points negate out. Now, normally, when I go to a Mexican restaurant, I always get fajitas, but here, I decided to get something that I've never gotten before, so then I can give an unbiased review so I can't compare it to anything. Also, whenever someone hands you, like, a really hot plate, and they're like, don't touch it, it's very hot, are you ever like... I do that every single time, like... definitely not. All right, so we have some brisket... enchiladas, so just beat like steak enchiladas. I don't know why this tortilla is red, but that's pretty good. It's nice.
Are you gonna leave a good Yelp review?
I'm not a Yelp reviewer. I feel like some people come here and they're like,
5 stars, paragraph 4.
What the
rice was a poor.
Spit some rice. You see that South Park where it's like, table for two, I'm a Yelp reviewer. They're like elitists. No. I don't ever review things, but I love reading reviews. Like when I go on Amazon, I buy things based off the reviews, but I never leave a review. Like some people, like when I buy a paper towel holder, I read the reviews and some of them are very in depth and like I'm like, thank you for this, but like I would never do that. You know?
Yep.
We were talking earlier, by the way, and some people on my videos are like, Max, you try too hard, try to be funny. Mona, can you confirm that I say stupid things periodically throughout the day?
All the time.
Oh, Kevin, you hungry, dude?
No, dude.
Oh, you can stop filming, man. Yeah, sorry. All right, so we're gonna wrap up the video here. I wanna thank you guys so much for watching. If you could just smash thumbs up button, it would mean a lot. It always helps out the channel grow. I know today was more of a laid back style vlog. There wasn't edits or structure or montages or super sick angles, dude. You know, I just kind of took you through my day. And I know a lot of people really enjoy these videos, these laid backs. Like you just wanna get an inside look into my life and whatnot. But as a content creator who actually enjoys making YouTube videos, when I do these where it only takes me like 30 minutes to edit the video because I just slap the clips together and I put up my color on and I, you know, render it out, it makes me feel like lazy as a content creator. And it kind of makes me feel like I've gotten to a point that I can just, you know, put up anything and not put effort in my videos and you'll watch it because I've gotten to this level of like success in YouTube. But I want to show you guys that I thoroughly enjoy making content, entertaining stuff. So I enjoy, you know, like I'm planning on doing an entire trip where I go out of my, like I drive a couple hours to go make a video just like focusing on like one segment about this drone. And like, is going out of your way to film something for a YouTube video, like kind of like, I don't know, not standard vlog, because you wouldn't do that if you weren't making YouTube videos. I mean, maybe a little bit, but I don't know. I enjoy content creation, and I feel when I do these types of videos, it's just kind of lazy. So leave your thoughts down below. Also, I turned 29 on Sunday. I'm not excited about it. I'm getting old.